Hello, and welcome to DigSketch, a channel dedicated to digital sketching for architects. Today I'm going to go over Procreate and some of the shortcuts, or what they call the gesture controls, and the quick menu. So let's start with a blank new file. So the first thing we'll do is set up different pens. What I have here is three different line weights: thin, medium, and thick, as well as a pencil that's pressure sensitive, a pencil that has a solid opacity, and then I also have duplicate layer. So the first thing to do is start with taking one of the existing pens in Procreate and duplicating it. So let's look at the technical pen. What I've done is I've made different duplicates of it, all of varying width. So all you have to do is swipe, duplicate. Now you can go into that, and under general, you can set the different size limits. So you just got to play with this to see whatever size you want to set yours to. So once you have the size set, you can rename it to whatever you want. I'll call this Technical Pen 5. So now that I've named this brush, and once you set up all of your brushes, you could set one up in pencils, set one up under inking, or any of the other ones. You could now access each of those in the quick menu, which is here. So now when you look at the quick menu, if you hold down one of these, just go to select brush, go to the type of pen you were setting up. Mine was under inking. There's my Technical Pen 5. So you could set all these up to whatever you want. And this one here I set to duplicate layer, but you could set it to drawing assist, delete layer, eyedropper, merging layers, new layers. It just depends on how your workflow works for you. So now let's look at setting up some shortcuts here with the quick menu. If you go to the wrench gesture controls, you'll see there are various settings here: erase, assisted drawing, quick menu. So quick menu. So I set mine to pressing the quick menu button plus touching the screen with my finger. When I do that, it invokes the quick menu. You could set this up to whichever way you want. If you just want to touch with your finger, if you want to just tap the quick menu button by itself, if you want to do a three-finger swipe, four-finger tap, touch and hold, it's just different ways to bring up the quick menu. So you just got to play around with this and see what is most comfortable for you. So the other thing I use is assisted drawing. So this is where it turns on the feature to draw hard lines, whether it's on a 2D grid or the perspective or the symmetry tool, which I'll show you in a second. But in order to invoke that, I press the quick menu button along with the Apple Pencil. And there are other ways you can access this if you play around with those. I've just found this to be the most useful and intuitive. So I just need to press the quick menu button and draw, and it's a straight line. The other ones I use are erase. I use touch, as in I use touch with my finger to erase. For the eyedropper, I use touch and hold, where I just tap on the screen and hold it for a second to select a color. That's with my finger. For full screen, I use four finger tap. So with four fingers, it'll just clear away the menu. For clear layer, I use scrub, which is taking three fingers and just going back, forth, and back, and it'll clear the layer. For copy paste, I use three finger swipe, which is three fingers swiping down to bring up the copy paste menu. So let's look at each of these individually. The first one was erase, so I can erase with my finger. The next one is assisted drawing. So to set up assisted drawing, or to draw with hard lines, first you want to go to Canvas, turn on the drawing guide. You'll see the grid pop up. You could go to Edit to adjust the size of the grid if you want to change it to isometric or perspective, where you got to create your own vanishing point, or symmetry. And each of these you just got to play with to see how they work. But I usually use 2D grid for drawing orthogonal lines for floor plans, elevations, or other 2D drawings. So once that's on, you could actually turn it off if you don't need the grid. But now assisted drawing is activated. So without invoking assisted drawing, I could just draw freehand. But as soon as I press the quick menu button, now it draws orthogonal lines. So you can sketch with a pencil with orthogonal lines, switch to a pen if you want a freehand over it. Another shortcut is a quick pinch, which will reset the screen to full screen. And so the next shortcut is the four-finger tap to clear away the menu. So that helps if you just want to just draw freely and not worry about any of the other buttons cluttering the screen. You could hit this button in the corner to bring it back, or just use the four fingers again. The next shortcut is the clear layer. To delete everything on this layer, it's three fingers, left, right, left, and that deletes it doesn't delete the layer, it just clears it. And then to copy paste, take the selection tool, take the portion you want to copy and paste, take three fingers, swipe down. You can cut, copy, copy all, cut and paste it, or copy and paste it. So if we copy and paste it, it shows up there. Now you can use the move tool to move it around. And if I'm copying something a bunch of times, you can turn that off. I have my shortcut here as well to duplicate the layer. Another nice feature when you're working with a lot of layers, if you want to start combining your layers, it's just a simple pinch to combine them into one layer. Another nice shortcut is undo and redo. Two fingers is undo, and three fingers is redo. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful. I'll try to do more of these quick tutorials in the future on a regular basis. As always, please leave your comments below, give me a like and a subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.